conference in the Bonington Hotel to rally support for a new party called iRexit Freedom to Prosper. Its main objective is to have Ireland leave the EU. It's also calling for a united Ireland. Its secondary principles state that it's a pro-natalist and supportive of stable families for the procreation, education and rearing of children. The group's been set up by Herman Kelly, who works in the European Parliament as a press officer for Europe of Freedom and Direct Democracy. That's a Eurosceptic group. And although he wants to make it clear he never worked for UKIP or Farage, he says linking them is an attempt to smear the party by association. The aim of the conference was to rally 300 supporters to officially register as a political party.
We want London rule out of the north. We want Brussels rule out of the south. We want Ireland to be a self-governing state. We want to leave the customs union so we're free to set our own trade deals. And yes, it would be in our benefit to make a trade deal with the UK. It would also be in our benefit to make a trade deal with the US, with China, with Brazil, with India, with the countries that, that in which growth is happening.
And what about immigration?
Well, if it's a choice between controlled immigration or uncontrolled immigration, we'll go for controlled immigration.
And do you not see it as controlled at the moment?
Well, EU membership means that 500 million people have an untrammelled right to come to Ireland. And also we want to have a say on the quality and the qualifications. If people come here, they're well qualified, they can contribute to our society, doctors, nurses, rather than just coming here as economic. Well, we don't want them, anyone coming here and just living off the Irish welfare system. The Irish people should be prioritised.
So who's Irish?
Well, there was a guy there who spoke yesterday, Ben Scallon. He spoke 7 minutes. He was fantastic. As I said, student in Trinity, 21 years of age. His mother is Jamaican. His father is Irish. He spoke about the need for Irish patriotism and pride and taking back control of our country. So obviously, there's nothing to do with racism.
So, Aideen, how many people turn up? What level of support did they attract?
Well, Herman says there were about 400 people at the conference. But in terms of support wider, it's hard to know at this point. The percentage of the population that's unhappy with the EU in Ireland, I looked that up on Eurobarometer. So 26% of those surveyed in Ireland between autumn last year and spring 2018 believe Ireland could face the future better outside of the EU. So would all 26% support, for instance, iRexit, would they want to leave the EU necessarily and identify with the other socially conservative views of iRexit? So I asked Dr. Owen O'Malley.